Hi, I'm Nirmal Goswami, Professor of Political Science at Texas A&M University, Kingsville. I'm very happy to introduce the university's Bhutan program, which is built around the theme of traditional economies and sustainable development. This is our 13th day in Bhutan. It's my honor to present the program to all of you from 11,000 feet up in the eastern Himalayas. Behind me, it's a 17th century monastery called Tatsang Monastery, most popularly known as Tiger's Nest. We have been based at Royal Thimphu College near Thimphu, which is the capital city of Bhutan. We have had many tours and field trips and also instructional activities within the classroom setting. And what you're about to see is a summary of what happened here in Bhutan. Thank you. Who has room?
I have blue.
Why didn't I get pink?
The shirt they gave me.
He told me to buy this shirt.
He should be getting gray and black, and I get green.
But if it's on your back, it's standing in line. Guy behind you? Camera, wallet, keys.
Everything's looking good. They're all on time. The attitude's good. We should be back in about 2 weeks. Hopefully, I'll come back to the same people that I'm going with.
All right, so what's your name?
My name is Juan Martinez.
And what do you think? Are you getting ready for this trip?
I'm ready. Nervous, I have mixed feelings. Excited, nervous, scared. Also excited.
My name is Stefan Choi, and I'm going on this Bhutan trip as well. It is May 13th at 1501 Zulu. And we're here at Corpus Christi Airport, looking forward to our trip to Bhutan. But now we're all here, and I think we're all ready to go, so it should be fun.
My name's Nick Brown. I'm a junior at Texas A&M Kingsville. Excited for the trip, just waiting to go to Houston.
Have you ever been out of the country before?
Yeah, I went to Ireland last summer, but that's a whole different animal.
Hi, I'm Richard Alvaraz, and I am super excited about this trip. This is actually going to be my first trip abroad ever, if you don't count Mexico City, which I wouldn't count it. And anyway, I'm really looking forward to this. It's going to be a new experience. I've never been to the other half of the world before.
My name's Ariana, or Nikki Arevalo.
And are you excited for this trip?
Yes, very much. It's not my first time going overseas, but it's my first time as a college student going overseas. I'm looking forward to just seeing everything, sightseeing. I've never been to a European or Asian country, so this is going to be something very different and very exciting.
Maggie, thank you, my love.
And what are you looking forward to on this trip?
The experience. Seeing a different culture and just, I don't know, I'm just really excited about it. Well, the people, getting to know the people and just realizing or actually seeing how their culture is different from ours.
Hi, I'm Cassandra Wallach and going to Bhutan. I actually went to New Zealand last summer with Dr. G. All of the different cultures. Primarily, going to Bhutan, it's going to be completely different than New Zealand.
What are you looking forward to doing in Bhutan?
Probably just finding out more about how they preserve their culture.
Poppy, aka Daniela Diriosti. I've been overseas a few times.
I'm looking forward to monks over there. I would like to see a bald, praying, peaceful monk.
I want to have lots of fun.
And what are you feeling right now?
Nervous, I guess.
Is this your first time overseas?
Yeah.
This is your first main trip?
Yes.
Okay, that sounds good.
Brianna Bates. Looking forward to visiting the hospitals and schools and doing speech therapy related project.
What is the furthest place you've been other than this?
Egypt, Lebanon.
So this would be your first trip to
Asia.
That sounds good. Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm really excited.
Yeah. We're playing Frisbee.
Where are you at?
The Houston airport. We have time to kill. And I don't know these people.
It's all about spreading some javelina love.
And an air bridge, I guess. Move over to the left because pass on the right here as opposed to the
US. Welcome to my world. We are in New Delhi, India. It's about 8:30 p.m. The plan is to go to the hotel and get a feel for the energy level for everybody.
How many miles have we traveled?
I think 9,000 miles.
Dr. G, what about the, how's the luggage situation going right now?
It's all good. Everything is where it was supposed to be.
Good. It's hot. It's worse than South Texas. It's like we're in an oven.
Everybody's chilling, having breakfast. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
How's your sleep?
We are walking the streets of New Delhi, and by streets I mean like we just walked out of where we were staying, and it's pretty awesome. It's completely different than anything you would imagine.
Thank you.
I'm like at a loss for words right now. It's like being in a dream. It's just another different, just another place that I couldn't even imagine going. Right now I'm just babbling right now. I'm just kind of surprised and happy, astounded. It's beautiful, man. Like, I've never seen anything, witnessed anything as beautiful as this place. And it feels amazing right now. The weather is fantastic.
So what was the flight like? I mean, it's, you just had any step over?
In India.
In India. What?
We came to India.
Yes.
So I just clicked the red.
It's ready. It's already going. We just arrived in Bhutan. The people greeted us. We are getting our luggage off of the buses and stuff like that. This place is crazy. I've never seen terrain this intense and green in my entire life. We're excited. We've been traveling for 2 days. We're finally here, so I'm very, very happy right now.
I'm just so excited to finally be here, and it's so beautiful. It reminds me a lot of Colorado, the terrain.
How was the drive up here?
It was amazing. It was very rugged.
Who's gonna do it? I wanted to do it wrong. So we just, this is about Belle. It's about the camera.
here, so you get used to it.
You take right to left.
Well,
I want to see this finished product here.
Why not? Because she didn't have got the jeans inside. Almost done, not yet done. Almost done. What are these coming to do?
No, I'll give you.
The runway, please. Good job.
Exchange programs is the opportunity to truly build something new. New friendships, new ideas and knowledge. And most important of all, a new experience. In the span of a few hectic days, you will make an imprint on our campus, on our academic community and on our city. We are truly grateful for this. We are grateful for the simple reason that the most important part of college is its student body. So by coming here, you are enriching and helping us to build and develop our college.
Sanji, say hello to
hi.
This is for the documentary.
Yeah, okay.
Hi,
what are we doing?
My name is Hemma, and I am from
Bhutan.
I am from and I am studying at RTC. I am studying
literal arts.
you live in North.
And I live on campus. Yeah. I'm room number 8. I learned the song too.
She knows it.
Okay. What do you think is the biggest problem?
I don't know. I think everybody's so cooperative and so happy-go-lucky.
Hi, my name is Sarah. I'm the International Relations Officer here over to Changwon Balhagang. And the temple is dedicated to the god of compassion. In Buddhism, Buddhist is called Chenrezig, and in Sanskrit, it's Avalokiteshvara.
My name is Karmongi. I work with Center for Bhutan Studies. I have made a presentation currently on cross-national happiness and its indicators in measuring the GNH index.
I'm wondering if these kind of surveys fuel arguments for the parties.
Probably yes, I think it's because
of you play up to them.
I just like it how they broke down happiness into a mathematical equation. I think that's really interesting, and how they take all these different factors into account. How population doesn't necessarily mean that there's going to be things affecting their equation. It's just real interesting how they explained it to us today, and I really loved their presentation.
How's the food?
They're like extinct species.
Yes.
No, they're almost like dinosaurs.
Probably
have to be a rooster. What is different?
It's probably taller than our state capitol building, more by a lot. It's gigantic. It's something that's really impressive that you can't just wrap your mind around, that people actually took time to create that. It didn't suddenly appear. It took work, and this is architecture to admire, for sure.
We are at the giant statue of the Buddha, which is still being under construction.
Look at this site right here. Amazing. Can't get this at home.
Oh.
My name is Samir Patel. I'm a faculty here at Royal Thimphu College. I teach in the Department of Environmental Studies, and that's where my main interest lies. My background is from the science background in biology, but I've gotten into environment here because that's such a big field in Bhutan. And so I teach Introduction to the Environment, and I teach Natural Resources and part of Waste and Waste Management. And these are kind of the topics of interest I have, in addition to biodiversity, sort of personal interest.
Tell me what's going on today.
It's supposed to.
What does that mean?
It's supposed to.
How often do you everybody participate in yeah. the sport team?
Yeah.
How often
they run, they play, they push, they fall.
Shall we go?
This is cool. Yeah, let's go.
Two-legged race.
Two-legged.
You should play that.
Interested people for two-legged race, please report to the ground. Bentashitop gen ngao sambo. Ngao nyo to bentignam. Salam chin and kunza. Thank you all.
Juan, are you ready for this?
I don't know, man.
That's a, oh,
oh my god!
Between the group A and political science and BC.
I'm just saying that I'm really grateful that we're in a Buddhist kingdom because we're all winners. We're all winners.
We were second to last, and then we were last.
How did we do? How did we do out there?
Great.
Well, they did well. I stepped on someone's foot, but you know, we won.
Dominated.
Dominated.
In a glorious battle between guests and faculty, we were able to defeat them in a game of tug-of-war twice, which warranted us this box.
Ta-da!
Tell me what's going on. Tell me about your day so far.
So far I went exploring over there next to our rooms, and I found this bamboo stick that makes really cool whipping sounds, and I saw a lemming, but from far away. And then we get to go shopping, so I have a long list of people to shop for.
It's our first free afternoon. We're gonna go shopping, see what we can get ourselves into.
At the discotheque.
like the market, and so we're just gonna see what awesome things we can find.
What up? What?
It's crazy.
Why? That's okay.
Let me hear them.
This is a street devoted to Bhutanese handicrafts.
I know just what to do. Now that you're here, I'm gonna come to you. Oh baby, you got me going so insane, and I just don't know what's going down. Oh, I try to get off my knees and try to find this feeling, but I can't. Oh baby, you got me going so insane.
Right now we're at Doshila, and it's a memorial. It's 108 of the stupas. And it's, I guess, a memorial of a war between Bhutan and India.
So we're hanging prayer flags today. This is pretty neat. The thing is, they have prayers written all over them, and it said whenever the wind blows through and waves these flags, it sends the prayers up to the gods in the mountain. So that's why we do prayer flags.
Bisa, what was in there?
It was amazing. There's big Buddhas. No, it was like, it's just art. It's so beautiful. I wanted to cry. Like, it's just beautiful. Like, it's worth the trip, man. They're worth the climb. It's, I don't know. Don't like it.
Can I see this?
Sunny here.
Marita, what are you about to do?
I'm about to ride a bike.
This is on?
Where did you meet these people?
We just met them right now. Right.
Where are they from?
India.
India.
And we take never pictures. Heard from Marita ever again.
Take pictures.
No, this doesn't go. No, this doesn't go in the movie.
No.
I've been sleeping here instead. I've been sleeping in my bed. Sleeping in my bed.
Does anybody think this place looks like Jurassic Park?
Needs more dinosaurs.
So show me family. All the blood that I will bleed. I don't know where I belong. I don't know. Thank you.
This is an amazing place. This is a Dzongkha in Punaka, the former capital of Bhutan. It's divided into two parts, the administrative part and the religious part. We are right in the middle of it. The tower that you see over here is a temple that divides the two sides. It's an amazing place. It's been here since the 17th century. And a great example of Bhutanese tradition, art, and the pride that we take in this. I hope all of you at some point have a chance to come and see it.
I feel like we should be making a book, like a picture book, you know, called Dogs of Bhutan. Just with all the dogs in these sleeping places. It's an idea.
Well, I think it's fine building jumbo planes, taking a ride on a cosmic train. Switch on summer from a slot machine. Get what you want to if you want, as you can get anything. I know we've come a long way, we're changing day to day. But tell me, where do the children play? They just go on and on, and it seems that you can't get off. Oh, I know we've come a long way, we're changing day to day. But tell me, where do the children play?
My name is Kunzang Chujin, and I am a woman expert. I think it's most important and the easiest way to understand and respect a culture is to know that their culture is different to yours, and that they may be very, very different and very weird on your terms, but this is what it is, and you have to learn to respect it and appreciate it.
When you crack the sky, scrapers fill the air, but will you keep on building higher till there's no more room up there?
The view is spectacular. I don't know if you're getting a shot of it, but pictures and video just don't seem to do this place justice. It's too beautiful of a place.
When to live, will you tell us when to die? We're changing day to day, but tell me, where do the children play?
So, we came inside the Tango Institute of Buddhism. There are these really steep ladders, and we're on, like, I think, like, the third floor already, and it's just, it's beautiful, and there are, like, classes held all around for, you know, the study of Buddhism, and we saw a bunch of monks. They've been really, really nice, really friendly, and now we're just taking in the view.
No one's up.
I know. It's like we're just climbing these stairs and looking to see what we find.
This floor is
the same way you go up.
How's that climb?
Is the same way you go up? This is the way you went up?
Is it? Classic.
Oh,
universe.
changed my life.
What?
It's so amazing. Like, the view. You okay? Are you okay?
Tell me something about it.
From 1650s or thereabouts, and the students are getting an inside look at it, because the head lama, the chief abbot, is someone that that RTC knows. So we're getting really an insider's tour of everything, and it's just an amazing place. It's just an amazing place. I'm very happy the students are here with me.
I love that, like, we got to ask him questions, because I feel now, after the answers that we got from him, that, like, Buddhism isn't just like a religion. It's more like a way of life, a way to do things, a way to treat other people, a way to behave. And I think behavior and morals and treating other people is more than a religion. It's something that spans across all types of religions. And so I think it was great that we got to meet with him and him to tell all of us that, so we can all think about it, because it's something that, you know, everyone knows, everyone's taught, but we forget. And so I think it was really great that we got to hear it from him.
I feel like I come to school for the betterment of everyone around me. I'm sacrificing my time, my effort to better everyone around me. And that's their basis. That's one of their main goals and reasons for coming to school, is because the end result is they're going to be better and help everybody else. And so I feel like I can relate really well.
In my life, I love you more.
Oh, wow.
And so they are a bit more advanced. Look at the dragon that they carved.
Wow.
Yes.
My name is Memo Chuk. I work for Lodin Foundation.
So we're at the Lodin Foundation today, and it's a non-profit organization here in Bhutan that helps children get through primary and secondary education and gives them opportunities for college and even higher education and entrepreneurship. And we donated, everybody here donated, like we split up a prize, and we sponsored a child for a year. And Dr. Goswami matched it, so we're sponsoring one boy and one girl for the year. And it basically, what these funds will go to is just totally giving the children whatever they need for the year to get through schooling. And if you want to donate, you can look up the Lodin Foundation online. And it's a really cool feeling to be helping a country that's so, that they're really trying to work towards giving everyone better opportunities to make their country better. And so it's just awesome to be part of that.
Do it at the side. Like, oh yeah. But keep it over. Keep it resting on your knuckle.
Aiming to kill the person just to hurt him, and I think I accomplished my goal.
I got a traditional Buddhist blessing when I walked through the door, which means that it's about this tall. So I hit my head right about there.
No one else around. The shimmer takes my eye. I lift my head. Blinded by the sky.
How's it feel?
Awesome. Like a rock star.
He is kind of like a rock star.
Should I start?
Go ahead.
Hi, I'm Nam Gizam. I'm an anchor at the National Broadcaster Bhutan Broadcasting Service. I'm on Twitter if you want to get in touch with me, at Nam Gizam. NamGizam. So because of that, I think the absolute freedom of expression doesn't really exist in Bhutan. It's been tempered with the argument that we need to be responsible Bhutanese citizens.
Knowing that the celebrities in Bhutan are only the royal family and our religious leader. So this is making my day.
My name is Karma Tanzin. I'm a faculty member here in Royal Thimphu College. I'm teaching in the political science department.
So this time, the new political parties came up with a new slogan. They said, this time we are going to articulate the interests of the young people, younger generation, at the same time, women, right? Give them equal participation. So what they did, they came up with, the two new political parties came up with two female leadership. Now we have two woman president, two male president.
Hi, my name is Kinle Tenzin. And I work with the National Council of Bhutan, that is the upper house, so to speak, that is equivalent to the Senate in the US. In the National Council, we have four divisions, and each division looks after a specific set of chores or works. My division is called the Legislative and Procedural Division. I look after that division. So basically, everything to do with legislation is looked after by my division.
My leg's not gonna make it up and down those steps.
Well, you can go to the viewpoint up there.
How was Dragon's Nest?
Hard and far.
What was the reward at the top?
Seeing something that nobody, mostly nobody, will ever see, that you can't even take pictures of to take back. It's only in here for the rest of your life. Or at least until your next one.